Thank you. You've seen in the last good talk that toroidal machines are pretty complex experiment. On the other hand, axisymmetric mirror machines are the simplest machines both in the scientific and the engineering sense. However, they were mostly abandoned because they suffer from the violent flute instability. Several passive remedies have been proposed and some of them tested, but each of these remedies has its drawbacks. The goal of my research is to use modern feedback techniques to stabilize flute in mirror machine. The experiment is done in a tabletop mirror machine. It's about 1 meter long. It's an axisymmetric, as you see. Hydrogen is injected through one of the mirrors into the machine in about one millisecond pulse. The hydrogen has a density of 10 to the 12, and it's a pretty cold plasma, about 1 to 3 EV. The feedback system consists of three elements. The sensors, you can see them here, there are six collimators collecting light at the periphery of the plasma, a different section at the periphery. The light is shed onto a photodiode, and the output of the photodiode is fed into a processor. The processor is based on a DSP board that can process the input and calculate the output within about 2.5 microseconds. And the output of the processor is fed to an amplifier and then to actuators, which in my case are needle electrodes immersed in the plasma and can be biased individually up to 600 volts. When no feedback is applied, you can see in the fast photography the evolution of the plasma column. You can see very clearly the motion of the flute instability. It evolves radially and rotates rather slowly. I will show it again. In the here you can see the plot of the sensors in similar experiment, and the flute is expressed in the sensors as deviation of individual sensors from the mean. Now, to model the feedback, you have to start with modeling the action of the electrodes on the plasma. To do this, we applied the step function on, to the electrodes and measured the evolution of the amplitude of the mode with the same symmetry as the applied voltage. Here you can see two cases for M equal 1 and 2, and you see that in both cases the evolution is nonlinear. It looks quadratic or something nonlinear. Here it's saturated because the plasma is just hitting the wall. We argue that the, to explain such an evolution, we think that the, what is going on is that the feed lines passing through the electrodes are charged gradually to the potential of the electrodes by a shift-limited current. So the basic model is this. We have a shift-limited current that charges a capacitor, which is the capacity of the plasma. In this model, on short time scales relative to the RC of the system, we expect a quadratic evolution in time, and while at a longer time scale, the potential at the plasma is constant, and we have a constant E cross B evolution, which give us a linear evolution of the amplitude. The implication of such a behavior on the feedback can be understood by looking at the simplest model for the evolution of the flute instability. This is the basic equation of motion by Rosenbluth, where force driving the amplitude is the centrifugal term. And we now add the feedback term, which is different for the two time scales. for the short time scale, the feedback term is proportional to the amplitude. And if you analyze this system, you see that it is never stable. Actually, what you expected is either unstable evolution or a periodic motion. While at longer time scale, it is simply a proportional gain. The force is proportional to the time derivative of the amplitude, and this system can be driven stable for high enough gain. So we expect an unstable system on a short time scale and stabilization on longer time scales. Let's skip this. The feedback algorithm we started to work with is the simple one we could think of, which is the local proportional feedback. In this feedback, the potential difference between two electrodes is simply proportional to the deviation of the sensors measuring the plasma between them. So basically, if we sense that the plasma is going outward, we apply an E cross B that sends it back radially, and vice versa. These are three typical experiments of three types. This is without the feedback, with positive destabilizing feedback, and negative stabilizing feedback. Without the feedback, you see the flute instability with its typical time scale. When the positive feedback is applied, the deviations are much stronger and the typical frequency is higher. While with negative feedback, you see that the large-scale perturbation almost disappear, but we still have a small high-frequency perturbations. If you want to look at it on a quantitative basis, we can decompose at each time step, decompose the reading of the sensors into modes, and look at the average amplitude of each mode. So here you can see a case with a low magnetic field where only M equal 1 is unstable. The other are just this is about the noise level of the measurement. So only M equal 1 is unstable. When we apply the destabilizing feedback, all the modes goes up. While when we apply the stabilizing feedback, the M equal 1 practically drops to the noise level. If we go to higher magnetic field, the two first modes are unstable, the M equal 1 and 2. And now we can see that both M equal 1 and M equal 2 are partially stabilized. It is harder to stabilize in this case because there is interaction between the modes and because the E equals B is slower at higher B. But both modes are stabilized, while M equals 3 is destabilized. This could be expected because for six sensors and actuators, the M equals 3 mode is practically unobservable due to the Nyquist theorem. A complementary picture is seen when you take the power spectra of the time series of the sensors. You can see here, again, this is average of several experiments without feedback. Of course, positive feedback increases the power at all frequencies, but it's interesting that the negative feedback decreases the power at low frequencies and increases the power at high frequencies. This is exactly what we expected in our toy model I described before. So to conclude, multiple input, multiple output feedback was shown to stabilize high density plasma in simple mirror machine. The feedback stabilization is most effective on modes with wavelengths much larger than the spacing between the sensors, like the M equal 1. High modes are not stabilized and even destabilized, stimulated by the feedback, but in our system and also in fusion-relevant devices, these modes are usually stabilized by finite Larmor radius and other effects. On small time scales, the feedback current is limited by the sheath of the detectors, and therefore the stabilization is pure. And we hope in the near future to replace the sensor and actuators we used in this research with other techniques that are more relevant to a hot plasma relevant to fusion machines. Thank you.
Okay, we have time for questions on this very original work.
What kind of sensors could be into high temperature plasma?
Well, there are many options. Right now, our leading options, which my colleague here is working on, is silicon photodiodes that will sense the Bremsstrahlung radiation of the electrons. But basically, if the system is large enough, you could use multiple interferometers, and some other options as well.
How many voltage elements do you think we'll need in the real case?
Well, I could show you that this system is, in the sense of the instability, is scalable to fusion machine.
Six
up between, it depends on the actual system, but usually you expect up to M equals 3 to be unstable, and so you need about 8 to 12 elements. Okay? If you look at GDT, for example, which is the Russian large machine, they only have an M equal 1 and 2 usually in most of them, the operation.
Thank you.